Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. So happy new year all. So today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Java on a Windows operating system. So to install Java, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in that this bar you need to just simply search with JDK download. So remember, it's JDK download, not Java download. So don't worry, I am going to put this link in the description, so you can just simply, you know, click on that link in order to land over this Java download page. So here you need to click on Java download and you'll be, you know, landed over to Java download page, and this link you will get in the description as well. So you can directly, you know, come to this page by clicking on that link in the description. So once you are here, you need to scroll down. And you can see that our Java 19.0.1 is available to download for Linux, macOS and Windows. So depending upon what operating system you are using, Linux, macOS or Windows, you need to switch to those tab and you need to click on this MSI installer. Okay, so just, you know, simply click on this download and it will going to start downloading our Java, the MSI one. MSI basically means Microsoft installer. Okay, so since we are installing it on Windows, I'm going to choose MSI installer. So here you can see that our Java is rightly downloaded. So just, you know, simply click on the installer and here just simply click on next. So I'll just simply minimize my browser, and here is going to be, you know, where Java is going to be installed. That is the C program files, Java JDK 19. If you want to change the installation destination, you can easily do that by just simply clicking on this change button. But I'll be recommending you to keep this default and click on next, and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and you can see our Java is rightly started installing. So installing Java will take some time, about, you know, 2 to 3 minutes I would say. So let's wait for some time and then I'll be again coming back to this video. Yeah, so welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Java is rightly installed. So you can just simply close it. So now that you know that our Java is rightly installed, it's time to do a very important step. So for that, you need to click on the search icon and here just simply search with environ, and you will get edit the system environment variables. So here you need to click on that and it will going to open system properties window. You need to click on environment variable, and here you will get system variables. So you need to click on path and then you need to click on edit. So this will open edit the environment variable window. So here you can see that we have several paths. So on here we need to add our Java path. So to get that Java path, you need to go to, you know, C drive. So you need to click on the C drive and then you will get program files. So just simply go inside program files and then you will get your Java folder. Go inside our Java folder and you'll see Java 19 rightly installed over here. So go inside that Java 19 folder and then you will get bin folder. So you need to go inside bin folder and you can see that we have landed over these program files, Java, JDK 19 and bin. Okay, so now you need to click on this address bar, then right click and copy. So what we are doing is we are copying this, you know, bin location. So you need to minimize now this and again come to edit environment variable, click on new, then right click and paste the path. So similarly, you can see that we have several other paths. So here similarly we need to set this Java path over here. Okay, this is a very important step. Just simply click on OK, and now it's time to set Java home. So you need to click on new over here and in variable name just type Java underscore home. Okay, and again paste that path, but this time remember to delete this bin folder. Okay, so just simply hit delete button to delete and keep it till JDK 19. That's all. Just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. So you are, you know, now installed Java. So let's verify whether it installed properly or not. Click on search icon, just type over here cmd and click on command prompt. So this will open our command prompt, and here just simply type java space dash dash version and hit enter, and you can see the latest version of Java, that is Java 19.2.1, is rightly shown. So if you get this similar message, so all that basically mean is your Java is also installed on your system. So if you face any difficulty, you can always comment. I am always there to help you. Okay. And if you like the video, please subscribe. Now what I am going to do is I am going to create a new folder. So I'll be naming this folder as Java practice. And what I am going to do is I am going to create a simple class. Okay. And I am going to demonstrate how you can easily run a Java program. So hello world.java, hit enter, change the extension to .java, just simply open that file with notepad. And I'll be writing a simple, you know, class hello world. And let's you know, open a parenthesis and close that, and type public static void main string args, and you know, open that bracket and close. And here in this parenthesis I am going to type system.out.println, right? And I am going to print hello world over here. So hello world. So just, you know, simply go to file again, save it, click on this address bar and type cmd, hit enter. It will open our command prompt right at this directory. Now we need to compile our program. So java c, and name of our file is hello world.java, hit enter. And you can see it has rightly compiled, and hello world.class file is also generated. So to run, you need to just simply type this time only Java, and then our class name, which is hello world, and hit enter. And you can see the output hello world is rightly shown. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of Java on your Windows operating system. If you face any difficulty, please do comment in our comment sections. I am always there to help you. So that's basically all about this video. Please do like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.